morning.
Good morning, sir.
I'm very happy to be here, maybe multiple times, starting from past 3 years. And I may be new to you, and you're all 3 years, huh?
Yes.
Good. Yeah, little brief about my background, because it may give kind of inclination towards what I will give you, or you can, to the point what you can expect from me. Okay. As it was narrated straight away to you, I was in VLSI Embedded Systems Design Group of National Institute of Electronics and Information Technology, and recently I joined Capgemini India as an image and video analyst. There are 2 points I wanted to convey in this juncture. I came across, from teaching to R&D to industry, many other things, and I think it may be the right time for you to capture what is required out of your graduation. What is required out of your graduation? Because that's a big question mark. What industry expects out of your graduate? In such a way that as a graduate, what you are going to give back? That's the first part. Second part, again, I will say that our system has a different objective in nature, so that you become different subject in nature. Because since there is a different object, to satisfy that objective, okay, you are becoming a subject of that, but that subjective nature is not originally required for application design. I think it's a bit confusing for you. It's an indirect way of explaining the happening in the formal way. Okay? Okay. In your own language, what is required in industry? It's very difficult for a student to reach up to that level in a short span of time, even after 10 years. You even take up a job, and 20 years back, the change in technology happens every 10 years, every 15 years. 5 years back, change in technology started changing every 2 years. Today, we are able to see that we don't know when the change is going to happen. Even my company may say that, no, what you are talking about, these things are age-old. Age-old means 5 years old. 2 years old, we want something new. Okay? This is a point you people have to attack. My topic is related to that. As an electronics engineer. No, I am not going to try anything else. I am not going to try electrical, instrumentation, communication technologies, nothing. It's pure system design. Because I think Saravan sir knows that I was there in electronics product design there as a system design engineer. Now I am into the part of solution architecture design engineer. Now from that experience, you can find it as a right opportunity to get it from me that what is personally required. And it is you to find the gap. Now what else is required beyond what I studied today? What else is required beyond what I studied today? Yes, it will be looking, something different. This fellow wanted to tell us something new. If you, maybe 1 hour, 1.5 hours, I don't know, till what time. This very small message, but this is your life. That's what I can tell you after 16 years of experience in the industry. As I told, as it was narrated, now I have seen, I was there in teaching for 9 years. Then I was into this government setup for more than 7 years. Now again I went to the industry, very few months, that's something different. But at this particular age, if I step inside any industrial environment, they will expect outcome directly from the labor. So my past 2 to 3 months of experience has revealed much more things. Okay? So the point is, this is what. The way in which you are going to take, that's something different. Okay? Whether you are intelligent, smart, hardworking, irrespective of what, if you want the career in electronics engineering, here these slides, I am not the owner of the complete concept. See, that's a very first declaration. I am not the owner of all this information. But it's an integrated approach of all the electronic subjects. It will tell you the purpose of studying all these subjects. Okay? If I ask you, why do you have, like, why do you have a notebook? Why do you have a subject? What do you want to study? What do you want to write an internal evaluation? What you call it as internal test 1, internal test 2. Your objective is? What is your objective? To get the first. Okay. But if we look at from industry aspect, your passing doesn't mean anything for industry. Passing the subject, having the degree, doesn't mean anything. Because today, we are trying to catch up with the olden days diploma guys. Olden days diploma. They are there still in the industry. You won't believe. BA Economics. BA Economics is sitting in solution analysis. BA Economics. You won't really believe such a guy. 17 years he is sitting inside the same organization. 17 years. After his BA degree, he has joined in some other vertical, he moved to Q-Tech. So, I mean to say, let us come to the whole part. I mean to say that here, you are degree, you are passing the subjects, you have marks, you have grades out of 10. Let it be. There is something beyond what you are thinking about. You need to do immediately. Okay? It has two things. One is short term goals, another one is a long term goal. You people have to catch up with the long term. What you have in your mind today, maybe in 2-3 months, I'm going to have examination, is your short term goal. Please do not forget about one thing. You have a long term goal. And that long term goal consists of too much of uncertainty. What is that uncertainty? Changing technologies. What is the change in technology? There again, see, the change in technology, this is very crucial. If you wanted to note down in your notebook, you note down. Because when we started our education, the era was different. When I was working, that was different. Today is something different. I'll tell you, there are three things for any person who wanted to be in industry. Okay? The first one, they call it as a language, programming language. First one. The second one, they call it as a technology. I don't really mean what they say. Whether it has a real meaning or not, we will not look into that now. Okay, first one is a programming language. Second one is a technology. They call it as technology. I'll tell you what all those technologies are concerned. The third one they call it as a domain knowledge. It's a domain knowledge. Okay? Now, the industry experts, at least the last two ought to be strong enough. Again, there is a problem. 15 years back, even 10 years back, if you know C programming, you will be getting a job. Even today, if you know Java programming, you will get a job. That's something different. Not as an electronics engineer. Okay? If you know Java, you will get a job, but not as an electronics engineer. If you wanted to be at least bit technical of electronics, minimum two things are required. Scripting language and technology. Okay? What is this again? Technology, what is this scripting language? What else is called as a domain? Yeah, I'll come to that part. So, see, the burden is too heavy. The burden is too heavy. Now, in what pace you are going up and catching up the things, reason happenings, to evaluate your speed, your strength, your intelligence level, your fastness, and your scope that you define on your career, everything is purely based on an individual, it cannot be commonalized. But scripting language. Okay? called as a 39-inch. But on today's application requirement, C has become it's very difficult to solve C programming because C has gone, C++ has taken over already the Hoops concepts. Even when C++ has dominated over a period of time, again with Hoops, Java has come and it is the biggest dominator in the industry with X1. Okay, because there are any number of packages on the vertical there in Java. Okay, again, the next era came. See, then C++ came, then Java came. Now, you see, based on the domain knowledge, now I am linking with the third part, based on the domain knowledge, the scripting language changes. If you wanted to go on web technologies, you take Java. If you go on any engineering application design, Python. If you go on any kind of analytics, business analytics, starting from economics, accounts, data analytics, you call it as a data science, data analytics, whatever it may be, then R is trying to, Tableau and R, R programming language, trying to dominate. And what is the situation of your MATLAB today? So there is a huge amount of things have to be analyzed and you have to be careful. What I say, within Indian industry, these are all the things. So Python, because I am working in Python. And let us come to the technology. So, like at this age, close to 40, is it really simple to study the scripting language and do the programming? Actually, I should not do. I am not required to do. If I lose that, in another 2-3 years, company will say that you are fit for nothing, you can do. Because I don't know what is going to be an automaton. Okay, if I don't catch up with that, then I will be simply a people manager. There are hundreds. You know, seriously, is very recently as announced. I think it's again close to 1000. 1000 in top senior level. Top. In top, again senior. Another 1000 is being counted now. I don't know when the announcement is going to come. So, the technology, again application based. If you, your machine intelligence has TensorFlow, graphics design has OpenGL, computer vision has OpenCV, image processing has OpenCV, video processing has OpenCV, and your Verilog VHDL has BlueSpec. So, like, if you want anything very similar to MATLAB, you have Octave and Scilab, and Python is equally well. So I have narrated the second technology part. What are those technologies? It's very simple. Let us assume there is a method, Thevenin's theorem. You write a library function for Thevenin's theorem. Okay? You call it as a technology. You write a library function for Thevenin's theorem. To apply the Thevenin's theorem, you call it as a technology. If there are more than 100 functions are implemented and bundled it, it will be called as a technological package. Okay? So OpenCV, OpenGL, TensorFlow, TiNanoHo, there are any number of packages. Okay, Tableau. Tableau is for data visualization, data analytics. So the second part is technology. The third, what you study, all subjects. Satellite communication, mobile communication, wireless networks, digital signal processing, digital image processing are all subjects. These are all called domain knowledge. Now industry is expecting, although at least 5 years back it was not the requirement. There will be one fellow, he can manage 50 hardware engineers, 50 software engineers. But today point is, if you doesn't know anything about the domain, it's very difficult to catch up with the technological packages and the scripting. It's very, very difficult, and the future is going to be a mixture of all these three. Any one scripting language? What? Configuration language, matching technological package, the relevant domain language. You have to cope up with these three. Here, you will see in my presentation, you will see, I am not telling all these things just because I am working in industry. No, I was there in National Institute of Electronics and Information Technology. Our job was electronics product design. If you doesn't know the electronics engineer, how to use CATIA. You know the CATIA tool? Any knowledge? No, I mean any information on Caltium? CALTIA Caltium. It's a mechanical analysis tool. Mechanical prototyping, 3D visualization, rendering, analysis to wood. Okay? To be used by an electronics engineer. From that to FPGA and we love programming. Everything is to be done by an electronics engineer. There I really face with the difficulties. How much we are lacking, or every student is lacking in the complete integral development of a product. It's very big thing. Okay? So why I took this much time to explain what is this slide and what is the motive behind it. See, you know all the subjects. This is absolutely not a good subject. So you can see that system design technology. The system design itself is a technology that we are not studying today. Which means, I cannot say that directly we are not studying today. We study, but we don't realize. What is the linkage of all these subjects? It's a responsibility of every student to realize what is the linkage of all these subjects. Where in your system design, in your product design, what is the role of this subject? What subject is going to stand next? And which is called as a fundamental, most fundamental, we call it as engineering business. And which is the most application wise? What are the in between subjects? To what extent you can play? There will be one or two top end application subjects, one or two bottom fundamental subjects, but within which you can have multiple verticals, many combinations. Okay. So I take system design technology, but I don't know whether it is for embedded system or electronic system. Simply I named it because we are going to little bit at least talk about processors, embedded processors. And again, it's contradictory one. I'm going to talk about the FPGAs and the synthesis. So the name embedded should not mean anything wrong to you. That's where you need to be careful. Because the purpose of describing these things is not to confuse, but you should not get confused just by looking at these words independently. Okay. It's an embedded system, it's not your typical embedded system. You will say, what do you mean by embedded system? What is the core part of embedded system? Yes? Combination of
hardware and software.
Okay, what is the hardware that you will use here in this embedded system? Microcontroller. Okay, this is good. This is what I even expect. But, this is where we are limiting ourselves that embedded system will definitely has a hardware and software. But what is that hardware? That should be a processor. That should be a processor. So there is a very big question mark in front of this data. Okay, that's where we lag. And before getting into slides further, they are something called codesign. Hardware, software, code design, and that's one idea. Then again, product design technologies, system design technologies. There are many things. Here, it's going to move towards code design. Software, hardware, code design. Okay, I told you, you need to keep one thing in your mind very clearly. I'm not going to talk about any of the subjects in detail. That is not required because you are much more learned fellow than even me. In your particular, you will say the syllabus, these are all the topics, these are all the blocks, this is what the programming, this is what the logic, I have studied all these techniques. That's there, it's there with you. Here the purpose is connected. Okay, I'm here to connect. So, the last point is, it's all, the whole presentation is all about co-design and validation. Okay, co-design and validation. It's going to be introduction, synthesis, verification, reuse, design process models. And again, there is a request. If you feel sleepy, you start writing in your notebook. Point number one. If you doesn't really feel sleepy, try to listen. Okay. This is the gentleman. If you really feel sleepy, you start at least writing. Keep something in your notebook. Okay. It's really required. But if you really don't feel sleepy, or if you are not really feeling bored, just keep your mind. Try to understand the meaning of every word or the sentence that I try to convey. Okay? Then it's up to you. You can decide. That's a third option. I think this is a bit lower. I think I can't do anything with that. Anyway, I try to. You can find the tab somewhere and you can look at what is there on the bottom side of it. You can take it. Listen. Any subject that we study in our curriculum is the part of the last circle. Part of only this circle. Again, I am talking about part of only that circle. We are not bothered about this complete, what is that? Client circle and end user circle. Client circle and end user circle. You can see, even in the bottom circle, we have to evaluate what are the things that we concentrate and where we are living. Okay, this is not required for my subject. This is not required in, as far as my examination is concerned. Okay, we'll see. Let's look at the last circle. Minimum number of errors. Hash means number of, because in the whole presentation, to reduce the write-up, hash simple means number of. Minimum number of errors. This is the first point itself. Is a highly contradictory one. When we write a program in our laboratory, let us take a 10-line program, okay? If you validate for errors, you might have written 10-line program, there might be more than 10 errors. There might be more than 10. See, I am not talking about syntax. What we look at, we look at syntax. That's what our duty is. But beyond syntax, once our syntax errors are cleared, our program will run. What we will try in the next, now we will try to extract our output. For the given input, it should produce this output. Even if it gives your output, I'll tell you, if it is a 10-line program, it will have more than 10 errors. Okay? So, in the first point, in our evaluation, we don't know whether our program will pass this criteria. Let us go to the second. Modifiability. I'm very sorry, we are not aware of it. What is modifiability? You write a program to implement Thevenin's theorem, okay, by Mr. Ramaswamy, and Mr. Kukuswamy is reading that program. Okay, Mr. Ramaswamy took one full day, 8 hours, 8 industrial man hours to implement Thevenin's theorem. When Kukuswamy is looking at that program to implement Nathan's theorem, he should use only 1 hour. Okay, or the next version of the higher in criteria rather than Thevenin's theorem. The programmer should take, or the design engineer should take, minimum time to modify the existing program. Do we really think about it? There is no scope. That's what I can say. There is no scope. This program is written to implement FFT in visual signal processing laboratory. That's it. This program will run for first for later. Now the question is, can you do a little bit of modification to implement DFT? Because FFT came from DFT. My question is, your FFT program and digital signal processing needs to be modified a little bit to make it functional for discrete. Discrete? Yes. Okay? Now, this is what modification. Now, if another engineer takes for one day, time duration taken by the first engineer to implement Thevenin's theorem, by taking the same program, modifying it to implement the Nadal's theorem, if the second person takes 2 days, it's absolutely useless. Another thing, he could have started from scratch, he could have written it in another one day. Okay, so that's called a modifiability. And I think there is no scope has been defined in your I'll give you a small tip. You will be doing some 10 exercises in digital signal processing laboratory. Okay? You just start thinking of it. You are writing a very first program. What is your first program? In DSP laboratory? Okay, leave it. No, I am not here to ask the question. If you can, you try to recall. The purpose of first program is to satisfy the need of the 50% of the second problem. The purpose of second problem is to satisfy the need of 80% of requirement of the third exercise. The purpose of eighth exercise is to satisfy 98% of need of ninth exercise. You are getting it wrong. If you start writing the first program, you just keep on modifying and implement the new at the higher versions of the technology and the domain knowledge. You try to improve for the very specific applications or even for the common application. From the first program, you should build the solution for the 10th exercise. From the solution of the first exercise, you should build the program for the 10th exercise. That means your complete semester's laboratory is over. Clear? I think this is not there, and this is actually expected in the system design. Actually expected in the system design. Otherwise, which technology performs better? If you wanted to eliminate the whole group, design group might be waiting for that particular software engineer, firmware engineer to complete the implementation for another 2 days. No. System is ready. It should be testified. Even then, it should have the adapters. You should plug this one or you remove, you use another plug, you check which is performing better, where the bottlenecks are there, to remove the bottleneck, which is to be modified, which is to be used, which is not to be used. So many things, that's called modifiability. Readability, I am getting to readability. Reusability, that's what. Very simple example, people start adding functions in your scripting language. Okay? I'll tell you one thing. Here, while writing C program and C++ program, we will see that only when we have the iterative recursive usage, we'll be writing the functions. But nowadays, they say that even that functionality might be used only once. Define it separately. Why? Can I accept for this question? The FFT might be called only once in my application design. Even it is being called only once, my manager will be asking, you write it as a separate function. What does that mean? You just give me your task process. Modify. Yeah, okay. One answer is, maybe for some other application, you are not required to ask the design engineer to write the same FFT again. Yeah, there is an FFT code. Copy, take that function, use it somewhere. So, this is a point number one. Point number two. Requirement number two. So, you wanted to give it as a reusable component. But there is something more beyond reusable component. Everything will be looking more similar. You can see. Modifiability, readability, reusability, adaptability. This is what product design is concerned. But as a student, it doesn't mean anything. As a student, it doesn't mean anything. Even when you do your final project, what the hell is this? Why should I? This is the functionality my project is working for this. Now, I have to blame somebody. either I need to blame even myself, the actor. For decades together, in the educational system, these two things were just because of their comfortness. They deviated too much. Reusability, modifiability, adaptability, these things are not tested in any of the final year projects. That is the prime reason where we are lacking producing efficient design materials. Okay? So, it has gone somewhere else. It has gone somewhere else, and this is going, ultimately both are getting opposite direction. This problem is telling that, yeah, I know all these things. I've seen, I studied, I passed. But industry has a fear that once we are committed, they have to give salary. In 2 months, they can't say that you go. It's a vulnerable group. Okay. So, industry has, it's struggling a lot to get the right people. But we have manpower, we have people with the degrees. Now, see, even you don't implement it, but at least you think of it when you do your experiment. Your teacher may not ask for the purpose of completing experiments for the examination purpose to meet the academic systematic framework. That's something. Okay. Now, if we start in this way, even I can't cross 2-3 slides, it will take too much time. We'll try to take the things with a little rate, okay, reduce it. You see, the next one is, we should not go to end user, we have to come to the client customer sponsor. Okay? Low cost, increase in productivity, backward compatibility, this is what. You write your program for FFPD, the backward compatibility is, you do little amount of modification, modifiability, so that becomes backward compatibility. What is this? Sir, what are these jargons? Very simple. I have an FFT program with me. I have a bus Fourier transform program with me. You do little modifications to that. It should have the implementation within that for discrete Fourier transform. I don't know whether it is possible or not. No, I am just taking it as an example. It is possible. I can tell you that whether it is possible or not. It's you. This is what? Modifiability and backward compatibility. Backward compatibility. Traceability of requirements, rapid development, flexibility, these are all very much sensitive among themselves, are little bit different. Anyhow, we will see, we will try to reach the slides which has a correlation. We will try to say something more. There you can see functionality, user friendliness, ease of use. Ease of learning, fault tolerance, robustness, runtime efficiency, reliability, portability, good documentation. See, yeah, this mouse may cost 300 rupees. Do you think that this mouse is not implementing all these requirements? It's pure electronics problem. Now, this 10 seconds. We are thinking, if it is open environment, if we all are sitting on the road, I will tell you the reality. Why it's not happening in India? We are not there. Since we miss all these things in our education, okay, we are not having products like this world. But you don't believe, there are a number of industries in England, around Sri Lanka, Kundamali areas. We only do the summary here in India. Assembly happens somewhere, but it's not assembled in India, I'll tell you. Then we went inside some of the industries and some preparatory things and we visited that. Then what we Indians do? We do summary. Since it is hazardous, they are not doing it in their country, they are doing it here. After that summary, it goes back. What for that job comes to India? Okay. Since we are not sitting on the road, we are inside sitting in an institution. then give things formally and to the required of things. Okay. So it's up to you to think about all these things. You are not going to think for this institution, you are not going to think about these things for your teacher, and you forget about me. It's a matter of 1 or 2 hours. Listen here. Why hardware design is too complex? You have to answer. Why hardware design is too complex than a software design? Now I know we are all getting bored or sleepy, and then I choose those people and we will have discussion. I am not bothered of those who are keenly watching the thing. I don't want them. Because somebody, when they get bored, I think this is nothing for me. Then I wanted to learn from them, what else you have to listen. Since you are something beyond, you have some other purpose, you at least tell me, I am trying to satisfy or I am trying to come with you. Why hardware design is complex than software design?
Why hardware design is complex than software design?
Let it not be software, something else. Why the electronic hardware design is complex? No, this is contradictory. The size is going down. You are telling that itself is a complex. Time constraint. Then why the hardware design is too complex?
Yes? Who told it's complex?
If that is the case, I will go back. Is it complex or why it's complex? What do you think that it's complex? No, why hardware design is looking complex to you? Yeah, fine. See, that is your view, very clear view. To design a hardware, we need a software. This software is helping me to design that hardware. Now, where the complexity comes?
We know all the problems, right, sir. After we design a small problem, we can design it, but we need a very huge order means.
Okay, right. I'll in better way, I'll try to tell them. See, if you take your hardware, this is looking like 10,000 gates, 1 lakh gates, 10 lakh gates. So many gates, and each gate consists of n number of transistors. So it's looking too complex. It's looking too complex. Why? Because since its size has gone down, they are keeping more, they are packing more in the defined size. That means packing more means they are packing more logics inside. Okay? There are more interfaces inside. Then high speed data flow, okay. Then many more things are coming in for a human to concentrate into that, for even 100 engineers to sit together and check whether all these things are working, how it is designed, it's very difficult. Okay, but if it is a software, you do one module, then you try to do the patch up work, integrate it, you can check there itself, okay. The thing is, okay, when you say it's hard, you take an example, an engineer from Qualcomm, Broadcom, or Intel, AMD, somewhere, an engineer comes. What kind of answer he may say for this particular question?
Will he say that?
No, it's easy.
It's very simple. Because there is another question which is hidden behind it. To design a complex hardware, you need a software. Then how complex it is? Will it be so simple? The thing is, I need a software to design a hardware. Okay. While human cannot directly handle it, why? Because it's too complex. I need a software to handle it. Okay. The question is, who has designed that software? Again, human. To handle such a complex hardware, you definitely need a software. The question is, what is the complexity of that software? Whether it is a simple, much more simpler than this hardware? There is one more point I wanted to tell you here. To design one particular processor, they will not design a software for that particular hardware design. The software should be for common to design many ICs, many applications, many SOCs, all these things. No? Now you think about the complexity of that software. The better examples are Mentor Graphics, Cadence, these softwares. You know how complex those softwares are, the packages are? More than 100 tools are there inside every electronics design automation package, EDA. So, no, I'm not telling what you are telling is wrong. You are telling is correct. In a limited sense. Clear? So, to design a complex hardware, we are building a very big, much more complex software system. It is just to automate, increase the speed, nothing else. Automate, increase the speed, we are introducing the testability while designing, that's all. We are introducing the testability. Okay, there is a multiplayer. You can simulate it, behavioral simulation. You can check it. And you can optimize it for timing. You can optimize it for power. You can optimize it for silicon usage. There are again three factors. Time, power. This is the biggest mistake again you are doing. What is the relationship between speed and time? Both are same, yeah. When you say time, then why do you again talk about speed? Time, power, silicon, space. Time, power, space. These are all three independent parameters. There may be a dependability inside, that's something different. Beyond the scope of what we discuss as a material. Okay? What is that? Time,
power,
space. These three are perfectly independent parameters. Perfectly. I can't say perfectly, to the most extent. Again, there will be dependency. If space increases, power increases. Clear? But there will not be any relativity with the time. There may be some other factor. We will not think about it. Now, we will come back to the previous thing. Testability. And to reduce the this one, static timing analysis, which is there everywhere in all prototyping platforms. Static timing analysis. And then again, power calculation. Okay? Then again, layout is there. In all the packages, there is a layout. Layout optimization is there. You can do. It's called the VLSI CAD. I think you might be aware of it. There is a subject called VLSI CAD, Computer Aided Design. There, it's purely concentrating on layout optimization so that you are reducing the silicon. When you reduce the silicon, the power reduces and time delay reduces. It's complex. I'm not talking about hardware. The target is a hardware design. But we are doing everything, the logic level implementation in the software. Only the software analysis. That itself has this much. Okay, what we come? Automation. We do it fast. We should not call it as a speed. We do it fast. And we have the full system established to test the functionality. This is the functionality. So it's there.
Now you see that this task of ensuring the correctness, because there it started, we have come to this line, which this has a direct linkage with validation. Okay, validation, verification, there are many names. This is what very difficult case in the ancient design, we call it as the olden days design. Specification, implement. How to implement? You manufacture PCB, bound components, test the functionality. It may not be working. Then redesign the PCB, redesign the circuit, connect it, check it. Then you bring out the board, check the functionality, it will not. This is what? It's forward and the backward. The backward is completely removed nowadays. Nothing to do. As one of your friend told that a software which is required to design a hardware, that software itself will say that what you are going to manufacture as an IC will satisfy your requirements 99.9%. They will not waste any manufacturing process, test already nothing. In the tool itself they will make it fine. Now I can go for again test. They will bring those things. They will run the benchmark testing. All the ICs will be kept in minus 20 degrees Celsius, 90 degrees Celsius, run all those junks, pump the data inside, make all the ALUs to do the calculations to the maximum extent. You try to make it functional and get how much heat it produces, how much current it consumes. Okay, what are the hot spots which transistor gets heated up first? Okay, what are the channels in which high current flows? What is defined? What is the level which is beyond what is required? Everything they measure. Parametric extraction, parasitics measurements. So everything they do, and they finally bring it as the final product. Yeah, any more things are there? We will not see that. You know, you are studying this two level logic minimization. What is it? What is this two-level logic minimization? You are in fifth semester, no? Fifth or sixth? Fifth semester. You know this? Two-level logic minimization. Yes? Somebody is telling. What is a two-level logic minimization? Is it too hard? If you go to next slide, he will tell you whether it is too hard or not. Shall I go to the next slide?
Okay,
you are getting a program.
Okay, you are writing a program. Step number one. Step number two. Debugging. See, I'll ask again the question. If you do you really do debugging? No, we will try to run and it will throw errors. What is the formal process? There is a run button, na? If you press, what happens? That you need to tell me now. First compiles, then? If error is found, it's fine. Let us assume it's fine. Okay, it compiles, then? What is the meaning of compilation and, what do you call it? First compiles, then executes. What is the difference between this? Compile converts to?
Machine language.
Wait. Have you ever done only compilation of your C program or C++ program? What is the outcome of that compilation process? What will result in your system only after compilation? Because there is an option only to compile. First you compile, then you check. If required, you can run. And listen, one more thing also is a, you are not definitely required to run the program. I'm not talking about compilation. Run the program by sitting inside IDE. IDE means what you say, your Turbo C compiler environment. There itself you are not required to run any program. That is there for the purpose of compilation. What is outcome of compilation? What will be there in your system? My thing is, you are opening a compiler, that is IDE. You are writing a program and you are storing it. What do you have in your computer? You have a program file. .c or .cpp. After compilation, what will you get after compilation? Only compilation. No errors. Let us assume no errors in your program. So what is there, sir? Program file is there. What else will be created on the same folder? What do you mean by binaries? There will be, see, in Turbo C, it will create an exe. It will create an object file, then it will bundle the runtime environment, it creates exe, which is not simply called as a binary. Your binary is object file. So object file can be straight away can be called as a binary file. Object file will be created. Object file will be created. Let us stop only with that. We have binaries with us. Okay? So software compilation creates binaries. Let us come to synthesis. What do you mean by synthesis? You just look at there, yeah. Everything is there. You just read and you try to answer for my question. What do you mean by synthesis? They will be studying only in the 6th semester. If that is the case, you have escaped. See, How do you compile your program?
We'll continue with that.